To start using the CR1 Studio, you first have to turn on the main power switch located at the top left of the equipment rack. You will also need to turn on the M-Audio box for the soundboard to be connected with the computer. The M-Audio sound interface connects audio from the program bus of the console and microphones in Studio A to the computer for recording or broadcasting. Ensure that the M-Audio interface is turned on and the volume knobs are engaged. Start at the 7 o'clock position. You should not need to turn them higher for the channels you want to record or listen to. Mac L and R on the interface for the audio from the program bus on the console. 3 to 6 is for audio from mics 3 to 6 in Studio A, which are all labeled. Ensure that there is a pair of headphones for use and that they are plugged into the soundboard. The board consists of 12 channels to which source equipment is wired, each controlled by on and off buttons and faders. Controls for adjusting the volume as well, headphones and cue speakers, and switches for assigning sound sources to program, labeled as PGM, audition, labeled as odd, and monobuses. When the board is turned on, it defaults to air, which is content airing in CR2. You will need to select program to hear sounds you're sending through the console onto monitors and headphones in the studio. The program VU meter will indicate sound levels right here. The soundboard should now be ready to use. You'll need to start the computer and set it up by gently shaking the mouse to wake it up or pressing a keyboard key. The password for the computer is located in the volunteer manual you received at volunteer orientation. If you are unsure of this password, please reach out to one of the staff. Once the computer is open, you will need to open your digital audio workspace you wish to record with. For more information on how to use these programs, see the volunteer manual or other videos available. Use Audacity, Studio One, or Reaper to record and for multi-track editing. Basic recording can also be done with Sound Studio. Ensure that the computer is connected to the sound interface. Click on the Apple icon in the top left screen, and then select System Preferences, and then select Sound. Output and input should be set to M-Audio. If M-Audio does not appear, check that the power on the M-Audio interface is on and restart the computer to re-establish the connection. To record, open a new file in Audacity or Reaper. Once finished recording, do not save to the desktop. Create a folder in Documents and save material there. Save material to the folder before saving it onto another computer on the network. Then copy the file to the other computer and delete the original later. If you would like to get files from another computer or drop files to another computer on the network, open the Finder and click on the computer you want to reach on the left-hand side of the window under Shared. If you cannot find the folder you need, click on Connect As in the upper right-hand window and use that computer's login name and password. Don't forget to insert a new track when you record and to arm the recording so that way you can see your levels and then you'll be right on your way to recording your very own radio show. For more information, please be sure to visit www.cfrc.ca. Special thanks to Queen's Television for producing this training video.